Hi, Ling.
Hi.
Hi. And thank you so much for coming and taking the time to show us the accordion. And normally we see the accordion just doing polkas or Western music, and you're going to show us how you use it for Middle Eastern music, right?
Yeah.
And how did you get started again on
I started playing accordion. I played for the children when I was teaching music at the French school. And then I extended my repertoire to Turkish and Balkan Roman, Afghan, Russian, and Middle Eastern music. So.
Excellent. That's great. Will you show us? An accordion seems so complicated. Can you show us around the different parts?
Yeah. So on this side, you have the keyboard. And these are the reed selection buttons. So I like to use the bassoon reeds and the oboe reeds, which are an octave higher. And then this selection plays both reeds. So that's for this side. And on this side, you have the bass buttons. They follow the circle of fifth.
So are you showing me a fifth?
Yeah, this is the fifth here.
So you. So you're taking one note and then going five notes above that, and
mm-hmm.
that's a fifth.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, and the reason the buttons are set out that way is so that when you play a song, then the chords that you'll need to accompany the song are right next to each other. Like if you're playing. So they're right there.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
So you don't have to reach all over the,
mm-hmm.
the buttons trying to find the
yeah.
right ones.
Right. So it's very convenient. It makes transposing very easy also.
What about these buttons on this side?
And then these buttons are the reed selection for the bass. So what I use mostly is this selection that we're on right now. It's pretty balanced. And then there's another one that's very contrasted for like special effect of old-fashioned or...
What do you call this thing in the middle where it expands and opens
yeah,
and closes?
Yeah, that's the bellows, and it either pushes air through the reed chambers, or it pulls it out. So I'll go back to this selection here. So it's just like when you play a harmonica, where this is...
What is that?
This is a row of reeds, and it fits inside of here. There's some other rows on this side. And there are two reeds for each hole here. This is a little chamber. So when I blow air in it, it will lift that little leather tab and activate the reed that's under. And if I pull air through it, there's another leather tab inside that will be lifted, and this reed will be put in motion.
So that's a piece that comes from inside an accordion.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
How many of those are in there?
Well, it depends on the type of accordion, but there are several on this side and several on this side.
Oh.
And the more fancy the accordion, the more combinations of sounds you can have.
And what are those little diamonds on the buttons there?
Oh yeah, that's some landmarks. So this is for C, so uh-huh. that you can always find C very easily. And in this one, the other landmark is F sharp. Sometimes the landmark can be E, but in this one it's F sharp.
Cool. And yeah. and now, what did you have to do to this accordion to play Middle Eastern music?
Okay, so the piano accordions normally are set up so that it will play the same note in both directions. Like if on C, if I play C here, or C here, it's the same note.
Whether you're pulling in or pulling out?
Right, those two reeds are tuned to be the same. This reed here and the one that's inside.
Uh-huh.
But in this case, I've changed the E and the B so that they will give me E half flat and B half flat when I'm pushing the air through the reed chamber. So I'll play E and then E half flat. And that's B.
And the only difference is that you were either expanding the bellows or compressing them.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Because it's a different reed. So
I
that's
see.
Why you're able to do that. So I'll play E, E half flat, and E flat in a row. So you can hear the.
Whoa. Now why do you need those half flats in Middle Eastern music?
So you can play the Middle Eastern makams or modes. If I want to play Bayati, then I need D, E half flat, F, and G.
Western music uses mostly major and minor keys, which uses just whole tones and half tones,
mm-hmm.
but Middle Eastern music has many more scales, correct?
Yes, many more. Many more. Many
and
more
they use quarter tones.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So you have a whole other expressions that you can
Yeah. Excellent. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Sure.
So where can we see more of you?
Well, you can check our site at helmmusic.com on the calendar page, and you can see where we're playing or teaching. We just finished a series of shows produced by Fat Chance Belly Dance in San Francisco, which included Deviani from Alabama, Kalina Shakti from India, Rakadu from Kentucky, and Rachel Bryce and Tobias. It was very fun. And at the end of July, the last Saturday, we'll play at a local venue in Fairfax called The Sleeping Lady. We'll play for Hannah Romanowski, Mira Betts, and Zoe Jakes. So you can find the details on our site at helmmusic.com.
And your latest CD?
The latest CD is Raksa Sajat. It's a CD to teach finger cymbals. And
that's on your website also.
That's on the website. You can listen to samples there. Yes.
And Spicebox is also on there.
Spicebox is also on there. And I'll play a little selection from Spicebox. Now, it's a tune from Afghanistan that's called Beto Baharan. Spicebox starts in Afghanistan and ends in Morocco. So here we go.
This presentation has been brought to you by Gilded Serpent.